all my days, I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night, you were close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God.
The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, Let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul. I'll worship Your holy name.
You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find.
Bless the His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. And on that day when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul sings Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
rejoice. He wraps himself in light and darkness tries to hide and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God, Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. Age to age he stands, and time is in his hands, beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead three in one, Father, Spirit, Son, the Lion and the Lamb, the Lion and the Lamb. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God.
Name above all names.
Name above all names. Worthy of all praise. My heart will sing how great is our God.
It's the name above.
He's the name. Our God, oh sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. Speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind, 'cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name. Burn like a fire. Oh, and
shadows burn like a fire.
Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the street, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus.
Shout Jesus from the mountains, Jesus in the streets, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy. Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name, Jesus.
Please stand. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. To this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, who by our sins are justly angered. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Lord, you know the secrets of our hearts. Shut not your ears to our prayers, but spare us, O Lord. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. O worthy and eternal judge, do not let the pains of death turn us away from you at our last hour. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother George Elliott for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother George Elliott. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence, we may continue our course on earth until, by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen.
of MB 6454. You need to move your vehicle. You're blocking someone that needs to leave. MB 6454. Angels, voices, ever singing. Please sit for a tribute with the grandchildren and followed by a tribute by David Callender.
Wonderful grandfather. Of all the special gifts in life, however great or small, to have you as our granddad was the greatest gift of all.
May the winds of love blow softly and whisper in your ear. We love and miss you, grandfather. And we wish that you were here.
Deep in our hearts, your life is kept to love and cherish, not forget. No more tomorrows we can share, but yesterdays are always there.
A silent thought, a secret tear, keeps your memory ever near. in our hearts forever.
Good morning, church. George was a choir member of this church as well. And it's therefore fitting that I should do this piece for him this morning. In this call, I know who holds tomorrow. I don't know about tomorrow. I just live today, I don't borrow from the sunshine, for the skies may turn to gray. I don't worry of the future, all I know what Jesus said. And today I walk beside him, for he knows what is ahead. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand. Every step is getting brighter as the golden stairs I climb. Every burden's getting lighter, every cloud is silver line. There the sun is always shining, there no tear dim the eye. At the ending of the rainbow, where the mountains touch the sky, many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know what's tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand. I don't know about tomorrow. It may bring me poverty, but the one who feeds the sparrow is the one who stands by me. Let his presence go before me, and I'm covered in his blood. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know what's tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand.
Thank you.
Rejoice, the Lord is King.
Rejoice,
The Lord be with you.
Let us
pray. Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant, George Elliott. And we pray that having opened to him the gates of larger life, you will receive him more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, he may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Please sit for the first scripture reading.
Good morning, church. The scripture lesson is taken from Lamentations 3, 22 to 26, and then 31 to 33. It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for him, to the soul that seeketh him. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. For the Lord will not cast off forever, but though he cause grief, yet will he have compassion, according to the multitude of his mercies. For he doth not afflict willingly, nor grieve the children of men. Here ends the reading.
Psalm number 23.
Thank you. The second Bible reading is taken from Revelation chapter 21, reading from verse 1. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." And he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life." Here ends the reading.
We now have a tribute by Peter Branch, followed by the eulogy by Audley Dalrymple.
This tribute was written by Peter Branch of Brooklyn, New York. It comes down to this, that today we meet to lay to rest the mortal remains of our dear brother in Christ, a great husband, a great father, a great Christian, and a great father figure. Today we try in our little ways to say how deeply is felt the gaping hole that will, for perhaps as long as we live, remain in the memory of things we cherish, things we like, and things we love. We would have tried today to close the chapter of mourning, as it were, for this, perhaps, this great man who will be remembered by each of us in our different ways. This is the kind of tribute which one would prefer never to have to make. One rehearses it in one's mind, and one knows exactly what one will say. But when the actual moment comes, there is the realization that one could never put into words with any exactitude the precise feeling of devastation, the precise feeling of some fear, because the reality has occurred that is so large in the mind as to be incapable of explanation. As I sit on this All Souls Day, penning this tribute, I recall that each of us who has had the benefit of Christian training is aware that death is not the end, that it is the beginning of another journey. And each one of us who has lost a loved one is also comforted and told that we can rejoice in the life that has occurred, and that we can be happy that the soul of the dear departed will move on to a higher plane, and that we must not be like people without hope, and so on. However, the final realization that the cold hand of death has removed someone from our midst who has affected our respective lives so fundamentally, still leaves us numb. I came to know George Dalrymple at the tender age of 10, and for the remainder of my life, he was a constant and father figure. I was a member of the choir, and so was he. He was gentle, yet firm. As young boys, he would correct us as if he thought we were going astray, but he was never rough with us. He was caring. I recall that on Thursday nights after choir rehearsal, he would assure that those of us who lived in the Bush Hall area were taken home. He would pack us all up in that gray Fiat 124 registration MF420 to ensure our safety. In my later years, I made a very comprehensive assessment of the man, George Dalrymple. On my visits to Barbados, my first stop would be Mansion Road to see Daddy and Mom Dalrymple. Even then, he was humane to me. From a personal point of view, I think it is this humanity that will always live with you, and the fact that in all those years, I have never known a single instance in which he was able to execute a threat into action that would harm anyone. He was too Christian-minded to do anything to harm another human being. My dear sister Paulette and my brother Audley, I must be brief, but there is much more that I can say about Dad, even speaking of him only as a human being. If you remember, he loved life. He lived a full life, and he wanted all of us to share in the good life. May thrones of angels lead him into paradise, and may he rest in peace.
Good morning. Eulogy part two. I want my father. Gonna have to rewrite the calypso because I want my mother too. It's been 600 hours or 25 days between the passing of my mom and dad. So today, we reflect on the life of George Elliott Dalrymple, husband, father, brother, grandfather, great-grandfather, great-great-grandfather, uncle, father-in-law, brother-in-law, and cherished friend, by sharing fond memories of the time he spent with us. George was born to Carmen Dalrymple and George Thorne on the 16th day of December 1931. He was the second of five children from that union, four boys and one girl. Brother to the late Madge Prescott, Arthur and Clyde Dalrymple. He was the beloved husband of Velda Dalrymple, a union which produced two children, me and Paulette. Daddy was a seaman when we were growing up. And Paulette and I, we cried whenever he left to go to sea. But then we got all excited when he was coming home to see what he brought us. His friend, Mr. Briggs, would come and pick us up early to go to the airport so that we could see the plane touch down and the passengers getting off. That is when the airport had a balcony. When he became a justice of the peace, he took pride in executing those duties. Daddy valued his friends. He mentored many young seamen and made lasting friendships with those he sailed with, such as the Brooms brothers from Park Road, Bushall, Dennis Miller, Leo Roberts, and Tony Rollins. His brother from another mother, the late Gladstone Holder, Vernon Foff Garner, and Cameron the Colonel Lynch, to name a few. After Christmas Eve service, he would have his boys over for drinks. Mr. Ford, Mr. Mason, Mr. Clark, and Mr. Merritt. There's going to be some reunion up there. Just last week, while expressing shock at his passing, his friend Tony Rollins told me how he was nice to him when they worked together. Audley Brooms, who also became a good friend of mine, would always be in touch and would call to find out how he was doing. Daddy's favorite place, other than his chair inside, was his chair outside on the patio. He and Stephen Sandiford used to have their evening talks, and he would also call Adrian King and Axe when he was coming to visit. Stephen and his mom, Wendy, they all chatted with him, and they brought him sweetbread, even though he was to stay off the sweets. Daddy loved to eat. After a visit to the dietitian, he was put on a diet. When Paulette prepared the portions, he asked her if she thought he was a cat because the portions were so small. Daddy decided not to keep up with the visits to the dietitian. Daddy loved music and was a member of this church choir for years. He hated to get to church late. He would say, "I sing in the choir. I have to be on time." On Sundays, he would play his records, Handel's Messiah, Mahalia Jackson, and Mormon Tabernacle Choir, among others. He enjoyed Independence and Remembrance Day parades and would leave home early so that he could get to the front to see the bands passing. He would never miss a police band concert. He would never miss a funeral. Daddy was always going to a funeral. Once he had a choice between a wedding or a funeral. He went to the funeral and then came to the wedding. He loved weddings also. He was honored to be his sister Judy's father giver, his niece Coretta, and best man for his nephew Tony. We thought it best to share a side of George from the perspective of his grandchildren. And boy, was that an experience. He loved them so much that when Ryan was born, he wanted him to be named George. Mommy had to tell him, "Daddy, he's not your child. Let the woman name her child." George is one of Ryan's middle names. He was a softy at heart. He drove Nicole to the hospital for each of her deliveries and cried each time as she got out of the car. He also believed in manners and would sit on the patio with Nicole, and if someone walked by and didn't speak, he would tell them off. Cannot repeat those words here. He would always call his grandchildren to check in on them, and early, and then would ask, "Why are you sleeping?" If he didn't hear or see them for a couple of days, he would call again and leave voice messages saying things like, "Man, the body ain't called George. I can't hear you at all. This is George Dalrymple, man." George used to ease and give them sips of alcohol to kill the worms and say, "Don't tell your grandmother." And he would walk Nicole home from school, buy her Kool-Aids, and tell her also, "Don't tell your grandmother." When reflecting on their time with him, Nicole remembers his love for Australia and how he met a Caucasian man with the same name. Breakfast whilst traveling was also a love. He would tell you how everyone would ask for a meager breakfast of bacon and eggs, but not him. He had the breakfast of champions, steak and eggs, whether it be on long flights to Europe or in hotels waiting to fly to another part of the world. His grandchildren had the same breakfast of champions. Cereal was a must, always first. Then omelette and tea. It must be full for church. Natania would go over to the house and read the newspaper, and they would talk about any social issue and cricket. He would tell her, "You can't let people come and try to unfair you," and then proceed to tell her how to stand up for herself in true George fashion. Again, cannot repeat those words. Yeah. For real, Granddaddy always told you what was on his mind, And we would always say to him, you can't tell people that. And he would ask, why not? Things people were afraid to say, he would say it readily. He passed this on to his grandchildren. And again, can't repeat them words. He was an awful driver, but he got where they needed to go. He would shout through the window telling people, move out the way, my granddaughter has classes. For Ryan, finally, he got to do the driving. So granddaddy would always want to drop to Howard for tickets. And grand would always roll her eyes. Of course, he was a passenger driver. And he always asked Ryan, you holding anything? And Ryan would willingly hand it over once he had it. Daddy was always interested in their lives. He knew what their school and work schedules were. And he was especially interested in Ryan's car. He would always ask Ryan, Betsy working well yet? That's the name of Ryan's car. Maybe because he wanted to go and get those tickets. His love also extended to his great-grandchildren, Kofi, Tishana, Aaron, Brooklyn, Chance, and Hunter. He took pride in holding them when they were born and watching them as they grew up. He was happy when his great-granddaughter, Kyrie, was born, but he didn't like her name and would always ask, when are you going to name the baby now? Nicole would tell him, she already has a name. It's Kyrie. He would say, that's a name too. As you can tell by now, this was George, take it or leave it. Mommy was the best person for him, because if you can remember, she was the boss. They were inseparable. He wanted to be with her. 67 years is a lifetime of togetherness. This was the true definition of together forever. We love you and miss you both. Well, this was penned by Nicole. I opened the door and looked for you both. Can't really say which of you I miss the most. My heart hurts and the pain has me dazed. Sometimes I cry so long and hard that my head cannot be raised. It's been 44 years that I've been seeing and hearing you daily. Now it's to never seeing you or hearing at all. I can't write, visit, or even make a call. I knew you loved me by everything you made possible in my life. I'm glad I showed my appreciation and gave you respect. For I know one thing we have between us is no regrets. To George and Velda, hopefully we'll meet again. Until then, I will always cherish your names. Now, I want to thank my wife, Claudia, for her unwavering support. My sister, Paulette, for making arrangements, and Noelle for being her rock. Leroy Christian, our personal funeral director. Reverend Suzanne, and also church, for accommodating us. Leroy Bailey. Sandra Jordan Paul, caregiver. June Sears Austin, who was inadvertently left out of Mummy's thank you. She was there early mornings with his barley and spent evenings with him in his room. Nicole, who was chief of staff. Natalia Wingrove, who was always there for him. Dawn and Tony Rice for your support. Veer Dalrymple, my uncle, the only brother we have left. Veer, we're going to hold you real tight. Dolores Hines and the Holder family. Trevor Rice, who could not be here. Theo Grandison, those who traveled to be here. All who called and checked in daily. The Delta and JetBlue family who called and checked in. Steve Caius, Bill Stetson, and team security, the Elliott Chargers. Father Chris and Emmanuel Anglican Church family, our church home. Thank you all, and blessings.
Hymn before the address, in our days of thanksgiving.
Acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. When someone we love dies, our response as Christians emerges. It comes to the fore. As Christians, we believe that God is the creator and giver of life, and that death is but the gate to eternal life, a richer, fuller life. The funeral service affirms and celebrates all that we believe, even when we walk in the shadow of death. At the funeral, we listen to the scriptures as they defy death. We sing of God's grace and of Christ's victory over death, and we place our loved one in God's loving arms. This morning is no different. We have gathered here to reaffirm our faith, to reaffirm our trust in God, and to place our loved one, George, in God's care. And to remember our loved one, George, a long-standing member of this church and choir, a brother who loved music, loved to sing, loved his family, loved his friends. Any wonder, therefore, that the members of the choir performed that final act of love by bringing his body, his mortal remains, into the church, and Mr. David Callender from the choir paid tribute to him in song. We've gathered here too to give God thanks for the witness and our brother George gave to God and to us through his ministry in song as a member of the choir and in his life. And though we are sad today, yet we can still sing. For if we believe that our brother George is in heaven, is in God's nearer presence, then we can be at peace. We can be at peace. Because heaven is a place filled with song. For it is full of God. And there are many occasions of song in the Bible. Two quick examples will make this point. In the book of Revelation, the Apostle John gives us some glimpses of the glorious singing that takes place in heaven. He writes, "And whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to him who is seated on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him who is seated on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever. They cast their crowns before the throne, singing, 'Worthy art thou, our Lord and God, to receive glory and honor and power. For thou didst create all things, and by thy will they existed and were created.'" This morning, as we sing, we too enter into God's presence, a place where there is no more pain, no more crying, no more suffering. Amen to that. The second example is that of before Jesus and his disciples went out to the Mount of Olives on the night before his crucifixion, they sang a hymn. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 26, verse 30, it is recorded there. When they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. They, Jesus and his disciples, sang praises to God, and this enabled them to go with Jesus as he went into the garden to pray for strength. The hymns that we sing here this morning, all selected by the members of George's family, do the same for us. They give us strength. For they are a gift to us from a loving God to help us and heal us as we grieve. Our brother George grew up at a time when hymns and hymn singing and choirs were even more a staple of our understanding of theology and doctrine about who God is and how we worship God and how we adore God. So they would have been close to his heart and upon his lips. And even as we sing those hymns and they speak of the doctrine, and they speak of the theology, we are reminding ourselves over and over and over again about who God is and what we believe he's able to do. So hymns like, "Lead us, Heavenly Father, lead us, o'er the world's tempestuous sea." That's a hymn that would have been familiar to George. "Three in one and one in three." I can't think of any Anglican who doesn't know that one sung at the Trinity. Or even as we lay our brother to rest, I think we have sung this so many times that I don't see it very often now being requested. "Abide with me." And somehow this beautiful one, because again we have sung it so often and people have associated it with funerals, "Rock of Ages, cleft for me, Let me hide myself. All beautiful hymns. All beautiful hymns. George would have remembered, even as we went through the seasons of the church and we got to the season of Lent, there is no way he would not have sung 40 days and 40 nights. All of these are hymns. All of these are hymns that he no doubt would have sung as a member of this choir. And so the hymns and him singing and his presence in the choir spoke well to his conviction about who God is. God is well aware that there is pain here today, that our hearts are hurting. He knows that we will need some time, that we will need something to give us the strength to deal with all that is happening, has happened, and all that will happen. And this is why he has given us his word. And God has given us a song. A song for our hearts that will enable us to sing. And I pray that in the times ahead when sadness comes, as we remember our brother George, that we will remember his love for our music and that we will sing. Sing. Because as Christians, we believe that death indeed is but the gate to eternal life. A life promised to all those who put their trust in Jesus, which by faith, because of our brother George's unswerving faith in him who died for him, we now by that same faith believe that he has. I pray that we will sing. Sing because, as one writer puts it, the hymns that our brother George grew up on, they sang and they breathed the praise of the saints, the vision of the prophets, the prayers of the penitent, and the spirit of the martyrs. These hymns, they bring solace to the sad, assurance to the perplexed, faith to the doubter, and comfort to the oppressed. These hymns that our George grew up on and that we too continue to sing, the writer says they span the centuries of history and they bridge the barriers of denominations because they speak of God and of God's love for us. I pray that as we remember George, that we will sing, sing because as Christians, we believe that he is with the Lord. And that should be more than enough to gladden our hearts. Sing, sing, my sisters and brothers in Christ, because we are joining our voices with those who are gathered around the throne. So yes, indeed, come, let us join our cheerful songs with angels round the throne. 10,000 are their tongues, but all their joys are one. O worthy the Lamb that died, they cried, to be exalted thus. Worthy the Lamb, our lips reply, for he was slain for us. Our hymns speak to what we believe, who we believe. They speak to our doctrine, they speak to our theology, they speak to our understanding of God. And so we say, what a friend we have in Jesus. That is why we can say it. That is why we can sing it. Because this is what we believe. Our brother George is with the one whom he loved and who loves him. He sings in another choir now, and here's another type of music. Let us trust that he has heard the words that he and all of us long to hear. Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of my salvation. I pray that Almighty God will grant us his peace and his comfort, and that he will truly enable us, all of us, to sing as we reflect on our brother George, so that truly all of his life, a life filled with God and of music and of choir and of hymns, not only will it be of a testimony of his life, but it will be a lasting legacy for us as we continue to sing. On behalf of the Reverend Canon Darlington, who called and is unable to attend here this morning, the Reverend Dr. Canon Sonia Hines, I extend condolences to all who grieve. I extend condolences as well on behalf of the entire parish family here at All Souls. We thank God for his life, for his witness. We thank God for our brother George, for the lives that were changed, transformed through his ministry in song, for his contribution to this parish and by extension our diocese. We pray that the God of all comfort will comfort you and give you the strength that you will need in the days ahead. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And now let us stand and affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed, the creed of our baptism, and the creed in which our brother George lived and died. You may follow on the monitor. I believe in God. Was crucified, died, and was buried. And is seated at the right hand of the Father. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please remain standing for the prayers.
Good morning, church. Good morning. After each petition, your reply will be, "Hear us, Lord. Hear us, Lord." For our brother, George Elliott, let us pray to the Lord Christ who said, "I am resurrection and I am life." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for George, and dry the tears of those who weep. Hear us, Lord. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Hear us, Lord. You raised the dead to life. Raise our brother George Elliott to eternal life.
Hear us, Lord.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother George Elliott to the joys of heaven.
Hear us, Lord.
Our brother George was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints.
Hear us, Lord.
He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Hear us, Lord.
Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our brother George Elliott. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Amen. Amen.
Our offertory hymn, "Come We That Love the Lord."
Join in a song with sweet accord.
may speak their joys abroad. May speak their joys abroad. We're marching to Zion, beautiful, beautiful Zion. We're marching upward to Zion, that beautiful city of God. The hill of Zion hills, a thousand sacred streams before we reach the heaven. Commendation. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Let us commend our brother to the mercy of God, our maker and redeemer. Deliver your servant George, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant George. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen.
Now thank we all, our God.
Minds and voices. Oh, wonder. Father, guide us when perplexed, and free us from all ill in this world and the next. All praise and thanks to God, the Father. Now lettest thou thy servant lead in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all. To lighten the Gentiles and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Eternal grant unto him, O Lord, and let thy Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you." George, into paradise may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem. Amen.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Worship Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. Worship Your holy name.
faithfulness, O God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not Thy compassions, they fail not, as Thou hast been, Thou forever will be. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness, morning by morning new mercies I see. All I have needed Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord.
I'm in all of you, where you're of the sea. Creation's revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring. All exclaiming, indescribable, uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. All powerful, untamable. Awestruck we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim. You are amazing. Lightning bolt where it should go, or seen heavenly storehouses laden with snow. Who imagined the sun and gives source to its light, yet conceals it to bring us the coolness of night. None can fathom. Uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. All powerful, untamable. Awestruck we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim. You are uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. All powerful, untamable. Awestruck we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim. You are uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. Incomparable, unchangeable. You see the depths of my heart and you love me the same. You are amazing, God.
To me, and it's why I sing your praise. your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips.
Savior God, to thee,
to thee.
Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hands are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. And at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. In sure and a certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother George Elliott, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our brother George, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing with as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of the great goodness and in joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon him and give him peace, now and forevermore. Amen. As we sing God's praises and give thanks and praise for the life of our brother George, we will do so using the hymns as they appear in the order of service of our booklet. There was joy in heaven when we all get to heaven. To God be the glory, and the day thou gavest, Lord, is ended.
Mansions, bright and blessed, He'll prepare for us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Remember, O Lord, this your servant who has gone before us with the sign of faith, and now rest in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to him and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. Together let us say the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.